So let's see, what is left into your syllabus, because we have completed almost the whole of the syllabus. There are a few topics which are left. Marshall, science is important. Studying sorry, media students is done. Understanding social culture issues, pretty good. Society, political society, relations, economy and society, social movements in economy and inequality, understanding current social cultural issues. Okay. So, social and cultural issues, that is the topic, and this is very important, you can say the topic, because a lot of time a question it has been asked on this topic. So the notes, it has already been posted into your Google Classroom. Everything is there, you can see. Even there are recorded lectures as well, so you can have that well. And today's lecture I have already put on the recording, so I will post the same in your group as well. Coming up to the topic, they are starting with these social problems, historical phase. They're saying the Indian society, being part of an ancient civilization, has passed through different historical phases. The Vedic period in India sowed the seeds of a civilization, characterized by the emergence of sophisticated philosophy, religion, astrology, science, medicine. So the starting history they are trying to discuss over here, like what exactly, how society it has emerged. They're saying, just hold on for a second. Excuse me. Students, I request you again, please use your college IDs to enter into the classroom, because when you will use your college ID, you will not need the permission to enter into the classroom. You will directly get into it. But if you will join from your personal email IDs, then you know you need to take the permission. At some time when I am teaching the topic, it will not display on my screen, because I have shared my other screen. So I'll suggest you start using your own college ID, so that you automatically join the class. So we're discussing this, that how this society has emerged. They have said that Vedic period, we call it where there were existence of four Vedas, we can say that, So that Vedic period, when we were actually worshipping the, Sanskriti, we can say that. So they have said that at that time, the seeds of the civilization, it has been sowed. And what it has emerged, philosophy, religion, astrology, science, medicine, Ayurveda is the medicine. So everything, it comes into that at that time. Then, now slowly they are moving towards the social problems. Its institutional base centered around varna, ashram and caste. Emphasis on rituals, higher positions of ritual performers over the others, and the sacrifice of animals. Now they have started coming slowly and slowly towards the problems. So kya problem hai wo aapke samne samjha rahe hain ki varnon ki taraf, caste ki taraf, rituals ki taraf, higher position, lower position, in sab ki taraf jo hai समाज था वो बढ़ना शुरू हो गया था. इवन दे हैव स्टार्टेड मूविंग टुवर्ड्स सैक्रिफाइसिंग ऑफ एनिमल्स. दे वर सेइंग दैट इफ यू विल सैक्रिफाइस द एनिमल यू विल गेट द सॉल्यूशन, यू विल गेट समथिंग गुड. द फॉलोइंग आर द मेजर सोशल प्रॉब्लम्स इन द अर्ली फेज. सो दीज आर द फ्यू ऑफ द सोशल प्रॉब्लम्स व्हिच वी वर फेसिंग इन द हिस्ट्री. कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन द टू मेजर सोशल ग्रुप्स, आर्यंस एंड द दसायस. We all know this thing that, there were two groups, the Aryans, to whom we call that they were worshipping the swastik, right? Then we were having the other group, which is they have sending dasas, dasyu means the Vedic texts, those who were the followers of Vedic transcriptions. We can call them as in today's time, we are, worshipping the Veds. So that is the starting of, you can say that, of that time. So ye do jo cheeze hain iski wo baat kar rahe hain. बेटा मैं रोज रोज इस तरह से लेक्चर रुकना मेरे लिए मुश्किल हो जाएगा, प्लीज कॉलेज के आईडी से ज्वाइन करो ताकि आप यू नो डायरेक्टली क्लास में एंटर हो जाओ, अदरवाइज यू नीड टू गेट द एक्सेस, मींस यू नीड टू आस्क फॉर द परमिशन। इंक्रीजिंग रिजिडिटी ऑफ सोशल हायरार्की, ठीक है, सोशल हायरार्की जो है बहुत रिजिड होती जा रही थी, मीन्स वेन इट हैज बीन सेट बाय द पीपल दोज हु वर द एट द फोरफ्रंट, व्हेन दे हैव सेड दिस थिंग लाइक यू नो वी नीड टू फॉलो द हायरार्की, हायरार्की ऑफ व्हाट, सोशल हायरार्की लाइक द कास्ट एंड द रिचुअल्स वी सपोज टू फॉलो एज पर दे वर टेलिंग अस, सो दैट वाज गेटिंग रिजिड यू नो हार्ड होना। इम्फेसिस ऑन द ऑब्जर्वेंस ऑफ रिचुअल्स, it was made mandatory for everybody to follow those rituals, you know that, you know when we get married or someone died or there are not many rituals we do in our day to day life, so what they have said that we supposed to follow all those rituals, so emphasis was given on it, zor diya ja raha tha zyada se zyada in sab cheezon ko karne ke liye, ye sab to kya the rituals kam follow kar rahe hai, isko kya hai, iske karan jo hum bolte hain ki koi uncha hai koi neecha, to kya ye social problems cause ho rahi thi, jisme ek aur cheez jud rahi thi, that was sacrificing of the animals. Jainism Buddhism merged as a protest against these practices. It is to be noted that during the Vedic and post-Vedic periods, the social position of women was quite high. The child marriages were not common in this period. Try to you know pay attention on this thing. आज हम बात करें कि we are you know facing the problem of these things. लेकिन अगर हम इसको ध्यान से पढ़ें, at that time they have said that there were, the position of a woman was very high, and there were no child marriages. India's contact with Islam has passed through the phases of conflict, gradual accommodation, increasing synthesis, and the revival of communal antagonism. With the advent of the Muslim rule in India, the two major trends were visible in the Indian society. Mughals ne jab Bharat pe hamla kiya, when they have invaded India, after their invasion, few changes it has come to the society. That's why we have said that you know society changes when it comes into the contact with the other social sciences. So other social sciences, kaun si, political science. पोलिटिकल साइंस हमें क्या बता रही है, इट टेल्स यू दैट हाउ द पोलिटिकल सिस्टम इट चेंजेस, व्हेन द पोलिटिकल सिस्टम इट चेंजेस डेफिनेटली इट विल इंपैक्ट टू द सोसाइटी। द फर्स्ट वाज द ट्रेंड ऑफ द ग्रोइंग इन सेलिब्रिटी एंड एटीट्यूड ऑफ अवॉइडेंस टुवर्ड्स अदर्स, द स्ट्रेंथन्ड द नोशन ऑफ द प्योरिटी पोल्यूशन एंड प्रैक्टिस ऑफ द अनटचेबिलिटी, द रिजिड रिस्ट्रिक्शन ऑन द सी वॉइज वर इम्पोज्ड ऑन द पीपल इन दिस पीरियड, द कॉन्सिक्वेंस फर्स्टली इट रिड्यूस्ड द स्पिरिट ऑफ enterprise and adventure among the Indians. Secondly, it minimized the contact of Indians with the outside world. कह रहे हैं कि ये सबसे पहली बात निकल के आई, क्या निकल के आई? आज के टाइम में भी आप लोगों ने कई बार इंडिया में देखा होगा कि when you cross the river, people they stop over there and they say, you know, pay obeisance over there. They वहाँ पर वो माथा टेकते हैं, पैसे डालते हैं. What it tells you that because that is the ritual from our roots. हमें कई बार पता नहीं लगता कि हम क्यों कर रहे हैं. तो यहाँ पे बड़ी क्लियरली उन्होंने बताया कि पहला जो डर था हमारे अंदर डाला गया, बोला गया कि आप इस तरह से समुद्र में पानी है उसको क्रॉस नहीं कर सकते, उसके कारण हमारी सबसे बड़ा नुकसान क्या हुआ, दे सेड रिड्यूस द स्पिरिट ऑफ एंटरप्राइज, ठीक है, एंड मिनिमाइज द कॉन्टेक्ट ऑफ इंडियंस विद आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड। सेकेंड, ड्यूरिंग द अर्ली फेज ऑफ इन्वेजन एंड कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स, द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ सती एंड चाइल्ड मैरिज इज वेल्ड एज अ डिफेंस मैकेनिज्म ऑफ द हिंदूज। अब इसका रीजन समझ के आपके सामने आ रहा है, हम बोल रहे हैं कि हम सती प्रथा को फॉलो करते थे, हम चाइल्ड मैरिजेस को फॉलो करते थे और ये कॉन्फ्लिक्ट सोसाइटी ने हमें दिया है, ये कॉन्फ्लिक्ट सोसाइटी ने हमें नहीं दिया, ये हमें दिया है ऑफ दैट टाइम जो पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम चल रहा था उसने। तो यू सी दे आर एक्सप्लेनिंग ओवर हियर हाउ डिड दिस हैपन, बिकॉज़ व्हेन मुगल्स वर इनवेडिंग दे वर यू नो फोर्सिबली मैरिजिंग टू द यंग गर्ल्स ऑफ इंडिया, सो टू or they were even forcing the married woman to get married with them. So if you must have seen one of the movie which was you know shown recently, Padmavati, in this movie it has characterized like you know Khilji was trying to marry the woman who was already married, so that's how she went for the you know practice of sati. So sati pratha hi isliye shuru hui thi kyunki unke andar dar tha ki iske baad अगर उनके पति को मार दिया जाएगा तो दे आर गोइंग टू अगेन दे विल नॉट लिव देयर फ्री लाइफ लाइफ यू नो दीज पीपल इन्वेडर्स विल टेक देम अवे, दैट्स व्हाई इन्वेजन्स के डर से ये जो प्रथा थी ये स्टार्ट हुई थी। चाइल्ड मैरिजेस भी इसी का ही कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस थी क्योंकि छोटे छोटे बच्चों की पहले ही मैरिज कर दी जाती थी क्योंकि उनको लगता था कि शायद जगह लड़की बड़ी हो गई और उस टाइम पे इन्वेजन हुआ तो उसको उठा के ले जाया जाएगा, सो दीज वर दी रीजन्स व्हाई दिस वाज हैपेंड। Only a small section of the Muslim population immigrated to India from Afghanistan, Iran, Turkey, and the Arab countries. The rest of them were local people who accepted Islam. Try to understand, humne ye pehle bhi baat padhi hai. It's not controversial or anything. This is a history which tells us that actually in India, we were from the Indus Valley civilization or from the Aryans. So we were not having these religions. So Islam, it has come from Mughals to us, and people in India, they have accepted it. They have said that very few people have, you know, immigrated from these countries. Otherwise, the rest of the people from the local India. Due to contacts with Hinduism and conversions, the Muslim India were also influenced by the caste system. Thus, the social hierarchies were introduced among the Muslims in India. Now, Muslims in India, this is a problem. Why? Because when they interacted with Indian society, those who came over here or those who converted from Hindu to Muslims, further, in their caste system, सब सेक्शंस ऑफ सोसाइटी उनके अंदर भी आया. कैसे आया? क्योंकि जब वो हमारे यहाँ पे जो सोशल प्रॉब्लम्स इनक्वालिटी की कुरीतियों की चल रही थी, तो दे आल्सो यू नो कम इनटू कांटेक्ट ऑफ दिस. दैट्स हाउ दिस हैज हैपेंड. द सेकंड ट्रेंड वाज इन फॉर्म ऑफ द रिवोल्यूशन ऑफ द कस्टम्स ऑफ द मुस्लिम्स रूलर्स बाय द एलीट एंड सेक्शंस ऑफ अपर कास्ट हिंदूस. दिस एनकरेज द अडॉप्शन ऑफ द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ पर्दा बाय द अपर कास्ट वुमेन इन नॉर्थ इंडिया. सो अगेन द पर्दा सिस्टम, व्हाई इट हैज कम इन In Hindus, you can say this thing. So, जिसको भूगर निकाला भी कह सकते हैं, they have said that was it has come from the Muslims because they were having the same you know system into their upper caste. So when you follow something from the upper caste, you feel like that you are doing good. So that's how the system of a parda it has come into our society. So it's not about religion. They are just trying to tell that how these things it has come into society. यहाँ पे हम किसी धर्म की बात नहीं कर रहे हैं. हम ये कर रहे हैं कि सोसाइटी में किस तरीके से जो चीजें हैं वो इम्यूलेट हुई और किस तरह से यहाँ पे लागू हुई. इन द मिडिवल पीरियड द भक्ति मूवमेंट रिजर्ट दी रीअसर्ट दी ह्यूमनिस्ट एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द इंडियन सिविलाइजेशन बाय प्रीचिंग इक्वालिटी स्पीकिंग रेस रिचुअल्स द कास्ट रिलिजन एंड अनटचेबिलिटी. उसके बाद मिडिवल पीरियड आया. हमने हिस्ट्री की बात की. मिडिवल पीरियड में करेंगे इन सब चीजों की बात होनी शुरू होगी. अनटचेबिलिटी है, कास्ट है, ठीक है, चाइल्ड मैरिज है, सती है, ये सारी चीजों की बात जो है दे हैव स्टार्टेड टॉकिंग अबाउट इन द मेडिवल पीरियड. आफ्टर दैट द एडवेंट ऑफ द ब्रिटिश राज, ब्रिटिश रूल, बट अर्ली ऑफ 19th सेंचुरी द कॉलोनियल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इंडिया वाज फुली एस्टैब्लिश्ड आफ्टर 1820. इट अडॉप्टेड अ रिफॉर्मल ज़ील. देयर वर सेवरल सोशल रिफॉर्म्स प्रोग्राम्स टू एरेडिकेट द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ सती एंड द ठगी वाइडली प्रेवेलेंट ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड. सो यू नो द वर्क ऑन to you know sort that problems, the social problems, to eradicate those social problems, you know, work has started over there. There were four major reforms which are done at the British Empire in 19th century. Brahmo Samaj led by Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Arya Samaj led by Swami Dayanand Saraswati, Prarthana Samaj led by Mahadev Govind Ranade, Ramakrishna Mission inspired the Ramakrishna Paramhans led by the Swami Vivekanand. So sometimes we confuse Swami Vivekananda and Swami Dayananda. Arya Samaj is for Swami Dayananda Saraswati. Ramakrishna Mission is led by the Swami Vivekananda. Brahmo Samaj by Raja Mohan Roy and Prarthana Samaj by the Mahadeva Govind Ranake. So these were the people, actually those who very forcefully, you know, revolted against these social practices. Inke against unhone bahut zyada awaz uthai diya, saying due to the tireless efforts of Ram Mohan Roy, the practice of sati was legally abolished in 1829. Itna zyada unhone virodh kiya ki 1829 mein isko legally sarkar ko ye karna pada ki yes ye nahi honi chahiye. The Arya Samaj contributed significantly in weakening the caste rigidity and reducing the practice of untouchability in Punjab, Haryana and Western Uttar Pradesh. Aap dekhte ho Punjab mein in sab cheezon ko itna zyada follow nahi kiya jata jo untouchability and all hai. They are saying that is because of the आर्य समाज, क्योंकि ने इसके ऊपर उन्होंने बहुत काम किया. देन दे हैव द नेम ऑफ प्रार्थना समाज, देन दे हैव रामकृष्ण मिशंस वर्क इन द हेल्थ सर्विसेज एंड एजुकेशन, बिकॉज एजुकेशन प्लेज इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. अभी हमने क्या पढ़ा आपके सामने, एजुकेशन किस तरह से रोल प्ले करती है, वी हैव सीन ओवर हियर. बिकॉज बिफोर वी वर हैविंग इन आवर माइंड लाइक सती हैज स्टार्टेड, जस्ट स्टार्टेड, हाउ इट हैज स्टार्टेड पीपल वर नॉट अवेयर. हम बात कर रहे थे कि सती हो जाती थी क्योंकि उनके हस्बैंड की डेथ हो जाती है इसलिए वो मर जाते थे. लेकिन एक्चुअल रीजन आज आपके सामने आ रहा है, वो बताने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि रीजन बिहाइंड दैट प्रैक्टिस वाज दिस. सो ये किस तरह से पता लग रहा है, एजुकेशन से. अगर आज आप एजुकेशन में हो, एजुकेशन ले रहे हो, पढ़ रहे हो, सीख रहे हो, उसी के कारण ये सब चीजें आपके सामने निकल के खुलकर आ रही है. Now comes to the second phase, which is called as the contemporary phase of the social problems. There are several social problems, though they are called as social problems, that in some problems, socio-cultural overtones are more prominent, where in the some countries, the economical and legal overtones are conspicuous. कौन सी है इनको चार उन्होंने अभी फिर सॉरी तीन कैटेगरीज में डिवाइड किया है. सोशियो कल्चरल प्रॉब्लम्स लाइक कम्युनलिज्म, अनटचेबिलिटी, पॉपुलेशन एक्सप्लोजन, चाइल्ड अब्यूज, प्रॉब्लम ऑफ स्केड्यूल्ड कास्ट, स्केड्यूल्ड ट्राइब्स, बैकवर्ड क्लासेस, वुमेन, अल्कोहलिज्म, ड्रग एडिक्शन, ये एक वन पार्ट सोशियो कल्चरल प्रॉब्लम चल रही थी. इकोनॉमिक प्रॉब्लम भी अब सामने आनी शुरू हुई थी, क्या पॉवर्टी, अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट, ब्लैक मनी. देन द थर्ड प्रॉब्लम लीगल प्रॉब्लम्स, क्राइम, डिलिंक्वेंसी, वायलेंस, टेररिज्म. तो ये सारी चीजें भी वो कह रहे हैं कि आपके सामने आनी शुरू हो गई. दिस क्लासिफिकेशंस आर ओनली दी नरेशन, दीज आर क्लोजली इंटररिलेटेड विद ईच अदर. पॉवर्टी इज एन इकोनॉमिक एज वेल एज सोशल प्रॉब्लम. सिमिलरली कम्युनलिज्म इज क्लोजली लिंक्ड टू द इकोनॉमिक फैक्टर. अब आप सोचोगे कि कम्युनलिज्म क्या है. बिफोर इंडिपेंडेंस समहाउ हम इन सब चीजों की जो प्रॉब्लम थे उसको हम फेस कर रहे थे, बिकॉज व्हेन वी वर नॉट व्हाट यू कॉल फ्री मींस वी वर नॉट इंडिपेंडेंट. सो एट दैट टाइम वी वर हैविंग दीज प्रॉब्लम्स, बिकॉज इंडिया वॉज कॉल्ड एज द कॉलोनियल कॉलोनी ऑफ यू कैन से दैट ऑफ ब्रिटिशर्स, बिकॉज जो फ्रेंच था उनकी अपनी कॉलोनीज चल रही थी, जो ब्रिटिशर्स थी उनकी अपनी कॉलोनी थी, पुर्तगाल इवन दे वर ऑल्सो हैविंग देयर. सो दैट वॉज द यू कैन दैट सिचुएशन और द पोजिशन विच वर गोइंग ऑफ ऑन दैट टाइम. सो ये सब चीजों को साथ लेके उन्होंने अब उसको डिविजनाइज किया. हम सोशियो कल्चरल प्रॉब्लम्स की बात करें, हमारे पास एक फोर्स फेस आया है, दैट इज ऑफ हिस्ट्री. एक फेस आया मिडिवल एज का, एक फेस आया ब्रिटिश राज का. अब ब्रिटिश राज में हमारी प्रॉब्लम्स चेंज हो रही हैं. कैसे चेंज हो रही हैं हमारे सामने वो हमें बताने की कोशिश करें कि तीन फेसेस पे चेंज हो रही हैं. तीन फेसेस यहाँ पे कौन से हम बात कर रहे हैं, ये फेसेस हैं तीन जिसपे हमने डिवाइड किया कि तो एक्चुअल में वही प्रॉब्लम्स है जो हिस्ट्री और मिडिवल पीरियड से हमारे पास चल रही थी. दो प्रॉब्लम और जुड़ गई अब हमारे साथ, दैट वॉज द इकोनॉमिक प्रॉब्लम. अब बात आनी शुरू हो गई कि किस तरह से हम पॉवर्टी को दूर करेंगे, किस तरह से अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट को दूर करेंगे, किस तरह से ब्लैक मनी को दूर करेंगे. लीगल प्रॉब्लम्स की बात आ गई, क्राइम की, डेलिक्वेंसी की, वायलेंस की, टेररिज्म की, ये सब चीजें भी अब सामने हमारे आने शुरू हो गई, क्योंकि ये सब प्रॉब्लम्स इस तरह से इन्हीं का एक पार्ट है, इसके साथ जुड़ी है. लेकिन इसको मिक्स मत कर देना, बड़े ध्यान से आपको लिखना पड़ेगा फेस बाय फेस. अगर सोशल कल्चरल आपके साथ में प्रॉब्लम्स आती है तो फेस बाय फेस यू नीड टू एक्सप्लेन. स्ट्रक्चरल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एंड सोशल प्रॉब्लम्स. अब देर आर थ्री थिंग्स दे आर वर्किंग ऑन कि स्ट्रक्चरल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन कैसे आई हमारे उसमें या कैसे आ रही है. संस्कृताइजेशन इज अ प्रोसेस थ्रू विच लोअर कास्ट अचीव्ड अपवर्ड सोशल मोबिलिटी ईदर बाय एडवेंचर और बाय इम्यूलेटिंग द कस्टम्स एंड रिचुअल्स ऑफ द अपर कास्ट. इट इज अ कल्चरल प्रोसेस फॉर चेंजेस इन सोशल स्टेटस एंड ऑक्यूपेशंस एज अ कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ द अपवर्ड मोबिलिटी ब्रॉट अबाउट द संस्कृताइजेशन मेक्स इट इनटू अ स्ट्रक्चरल प्रोसेस. इसको बेसिकली हम एजुकेशन बोल सकते हैं. Sanskritization means to say that education, because of the equal right of education to everybody, when everybody has studied it, so you know the changes it has come that you know people, those who were considered earlier as the what do you call people from the upper caste. Guys, just hold for a second. So they have said that with the advent of education, somehow when everybody has read everything, everybody knew the actual reasons of these things. So ek parda jo dimag mein pada hua tha sabke, that has you know gone away. Sabka wo clear ho gaya vision, aur sabko pata lag gaya ki yes, everybody is equal. Hum is basis ke upar kisi ke sath discrimination kar nahi kar sakte hain. everybody is equal by birth. When we are human, we are human, that's it. So that was the one concept jo yahan pe aaya. Ispe aane ka karan kahan se hai? They have said that when we came into the contact with the west, particularly with the England, set in motion another process of transmission in India known as westernization. Ab second step jo hamara pada education ka, hame dusri countries ke bare mein pata laga. England hamare upar invade kar chuka tha, so we started reading their literature, their text. So we got to know about like how these people are living, what they are doing, how they are different from us, or how they are good from us. So we understood the pattern of administration, their legal system, education system through the English language. Because now Sanskritization means education. Education हमारे पास आ चुकी थी, अब हमने English literature पढ़ना शुरू किया. So we got to know about how these people are living and how they are leading their life, किस तरह से legal life and the other सेट ऑफ सोशल जो सिस्टम है उनके वहां पर वो चल रहा है. ओके, इट ब्रॉट अबाउट स्ट्रक्चरल चेंजेस बाय द ग्रोथ ऑफ मॉडर्न ऑक्यूपेंसीज रिलेटेड टू द मॉडर्न एजुकेशन इकोनॉमी एंड इंडस्ट्री इमेजेस ऑफ अर्बन सेंटर्स विद द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ कॉलोनियल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड द राइज ऑफ अर्बन मिडिल क्लास अंडर द इंपैक्ट ऑफ एजुकेशन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन जुडिशरी एंड प्रेस. As explained earlier, modernization and westernization are closely related in the Indian context. So, third jo concept unhone bataya hai, that is of modernization, wo kis tarah se aaya, they have already explained ki isko hum zyada dur nahi kar sakte hain isse, jo ki humne second part abhi padha hai, that is of westernization. So, westernization or the modernization, and that's very close to it because hum jab unka context padh rahe the, we got to realize this thing that how these people have got the life they are leading these days. So that's how hamare India mein bhi industries ke upar exposure hua. We started setting up the industries over here. Jo entrepreneurship ka ek concept hai wo hamare yahan pe aaya. Migration honi shuru hui ek jagah se dusri jagah. Pehle hum ek gaon se dusre gaon mein nikalte the. Ab people from Bengal, they have come to Punjab. Punjab people went to Maharashtra. So this has started going. Money, market, modern technology, communication network, industrialization. So all these things are part of modernization. Now we come up to itna jada isme jo 20 ka part hai usko hum nahi cover karenge, because that is a very big topic. We just come up to that, we understood how the system it has come up to, because hum history se chade, aaj ki jo time hai yahan tak hum pahunch gaye hain. Ab we have come up to the actual things, that is what you call the social problems in India mein jo social problem usse hum deal kar rahe hain. What are those problems? Okay, the very first problem, the social cultural problem, that is religion. The multi-religious nature of society and the conflict among the different religions has given rise to the problem of communalism in India. The phenomenon of communalism is a vitiated form of inter-religious group in relationship, particularly between Hindus and Muslims, is a grave problem in India. It has its historical linkage with the Muslim regions in India, early conflicts between Hindus and Muslims, British rule, and the policy of encouraging criminal divide, competition for political power, services and resources. Religion ek bahut badi problem hai India mein, bahut bada social issue hai yahan par, cultural issue hai. We have a multicultural society, even sub sections are divided. Ek hi culture ka rashtra ke andar bahut sare hum Hindus ki agar baat kare, they are not Hindus, they have Jaini, they are Buddhism, they are into lot many other sub sections, chote chote se jisko bole. But major problem it comes on the names of like Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christians. Even Britishers, they took the advantage of our mindset, and that is how they have divided the country, not on the base of geography. They divided the country on the base of religion, that one country is given to the people, those who are the followers of Islam, and one country is divided or given to the. So that thing it has come into somehow into the minds of our people, and still we are facing that problem of criminalism. Gradually ये problem जो है has affected the Hindu Sikh relations also. तो पहले ये थी, अब यहाँ पे आगे आगे ये बोल रहे हैं कि धीरे 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 ये problem और बढ़ती जा रही है, और this is how we are dealing with and explained the thing that has been given over here, how we are becoming the soft target for it. Even other countries, they are taking advantage of it. They know this thing that अगर भारत में लड़ाई करानी हो तो सबसे बढ़िया तरीका क्या है कि यहाँ पे religion के नाम पे हम दंगे करवा सकते हैं. The second problem we face, that is caste. The caste system has divided the Indian population into numerous groups. As I've said that in Hindus we have a subsections. Similarly, we have very very deep caste system. Like we have too many castes. Sometimes we don't understand that what you're talking about. Because people say that I am from this caste, this section, this subsection, this is subsection. So the thing is very confused. But people are believing it. A lot of social institutions are working on it. So that because of conflicts, it comes out in the form of tension. So they have said that that is again another problem that we are facing, our society is facing. Then we have a problem of language. We call India, we call Hindi as the Indian language or the national language, but we all know that how many of us know this language. Because we are more towards again rigidity. We are too much rigid on one thing, that if I am from Punjab, I would be more towards Punjabi. If I am from Gujarat, I'll be more towards Gujarati. I'll be more towards Haryanvi. I'll be more towards Kashmiri. Nobody talks about I am more towards Indian. Nobody talks about India. People talks about the states. So that's again a problem. Language is to unite you, but here what is the problem? Language is dividing you. Then we still have the population of tribes. A large population of people, they are living into the tribes. You are from Punjab, so you probably will not understand that. But if you go towards northeast side of India, a lot of people, they are living into the tribes. So still we have that people, those who are into it. And the problem is at both ends. Those who are from the non-tribal side, they are trying to exploit the tribes, and the tribes are not getting what they are actually they are expecting or what is their right. The problem, it comes again into our society. So main problem for the tribes are backwardness, exploitation, these different kind of things, it happens into the tribal parts. Minorities, that's a big problem on the basis of language or on the basis of caste or on the basis of religion. We have a lot of minority groups. So that's again a problem. Population explosion. Reason, it varies. I cannot comment on this thing that what is the reason, but they are saying that is again becoming the very big problem for India. Because population increasing. People probably towards religion or towards caste or towards any other reason, I don't know. But somehow everybody is into the multiplying this thing, and that is how we are into a trouble, because it directly burdens onto the country. Because when you talk about jobs and how many competitors do you see, so if it has a job of one, and I think 50,000 or 1 lakh people will stand for that one, means these many people are over there. And how people are getting easy jobs in other countries, because they have a less competition. That's again a problem for us, rising population. They have even given the chart over here, like how the social demographic profile of states in India. Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal, Punjab, persons, growth rate, sex ratio, density, literacy rate. Everything is mentioned over here. In Punjab, you talk about literacy rate of men is 75 and 63 of female. So that's a complete chart which is given over here. There are a few questions even it has been mentioned, but we will not attempt these questions because this does not belong to us. And that was the social problems. Now come up to the cultural problems. Okay. First is fatalism. The cultural element that has been relevant to social problems in India is fatalism. The Hindu doctrines of karma and rebirth contain strong elements of fatalistic attitude to life. The attitude of acceptance of and resignation to the vicissitudes and failures in life. So, हमें निकम्मा बनाने के लिए कह रहे हैं, सबसे बड़ी बात यह कि हम जो है किस्मत के ऊपर बैठ जाते हैं. ये तो मेरी फेट है, ये तो मेरी किस्मत है, जो किस्मत में लिखा होता वो हो गया. अगर हम सक्सेसफुल हो रहे हैं तो किस्मत के आ रहे हैं, फेलियर हो रही है तो किस्मत के कारण कर रहे हैं. तो लोग आगे बढ़ी नहीं रहे. सोशल प्रैक्टिस सच एज अनटचेबिलिटी, डिस्क्रिमिनेशन, बॉन्डेड लेबर पर्सिस्टेड इंडिया फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम ऑलमोस्ट अनचैलेंज्ड बाय दोज अफेक्टेड बाय देम. इट हैपेंड सो बिकॉज़ द अफेक्टेड पीपल कंसीडर्ड दीज पर्टिकुलर्स आर रिजल्ट ऑफ देयर कर्मा और द प्रीवियस बर्थ एंड लक. तो ये कल्चरल इशू है. Then the second is particularism. Another cultural trait widespread in Indian society is particularism as against universalism. This is reflected in the excessive consideration of one's own people, own caste, own religion, own group. तो ये बहुत problem हो रही है कि मेरा जो particular area है, मैं सिर्फ उनको support करूँगा, मैं बाकियों से मेरा कुछ लेना देना नहीं. People, they don't talk about the country. They people, they talk about one part. So again, I don't want to comment on anything, but whatever it is happening in front of you, you see that we are not seeing the broader way as whole India. We are seeing as one part. If I'm from Punjab, I will just talk about Punjab. If I'm from other state, I'll talk about another state. So that's again a big problem. Attitude of public property. Public property ki kisi ko koi dhyan nahi hai. हमें एड्स बनानी पड़ती है. रेलवे आप लोगों की पब्लिक संपत्ति है. क्यों बनानी पड़ती है? बिकॉज वी आर डिसरिगार्डिंग वेयर एवर वी गो एंड दैट इज द पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी. हम उसको रिम करने की कोशिश करते हैं, हम उसको खराब करने की कोशिश करते हैं. ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाट द एटीट्यूड ऑफ अस व्हिच इज गोइंग ऑन. वी सपोज टू सी दिस थिंग बिकॉज When you reach, that's not only what you can say that this is our, you know, the conscious should be, you know, allowed to do these things. Because if you're going, you're traveling into railways and if you're seeing that, you know, we are eating, what do you call, something and you're throwing, you know, that instead of keeping it and later on when you will have the access to the dustbin, you can throw it over there. But what we are doing, we are throwing it over there. Why we are doing it? In the college, we can take example of, you know, when I have seen this thing that, you know, when the sweepers, they clean your rooms, I have seen the packets of chips. I've seen other kinds of litters over there. So what does it mean? Because we have the feeling of this thing that it does not belong to us. So they are trying to tell you this thing. The attitude of the public property means that is the property of a country of yours. Everything is built up for you, for the betterment of yours. If you will not understand that thing, how could you go further? Lack of respect of public property is one of the root cause of corruption, right? So why the corruption is, try to understand the linkage of this thing. Why corruption, it is started over here. That is the root cause. What is the root cause? Because when you do not feel the attachment, you do, you give license to somebody, the driving license, for example, by getting the money from that person. And you are thinking that you have actually completed your self-interest. आपने अपना जो self-interest था उसको तो पूरा कर लिया. लेकिन जिसको आप driving license दे रहे हो सकता है वही बंदा कल आपके family member के ऊपर गाड़ी चला दे. ये direct indirect connection बन रहा है क्योंकि हम लोग सिर्फ अपने साथ self जिसको बोल सकते हैं चीजों को जोड़ के देख रहे हैं. Black money, tax evasions, misappropriation of the public goods, use of substandard materials in the public constructions, everything if you see, that is actually the reason of this thing. Okay? So these are all what you call the cultural problems. So we started from, I go up again towards, we started from from where the Vedic period, where we have started the things, then we come up to the cultural issues. Then we have come up to the social issues. Then we have come up to the cultural issues. So the question is this, what are the social and cultural, socio-cultural issues, social cultural issues, these, there are different ways it can be asked. So ye sab cheeze humne yahan pe discuss kar di. Main yahan pe lecture aaj ka end kar raha hu aur jo 5 minutes last ke hain uske liye main aapse ye pooch raha hu ki if you have any of the questions related to it, aap mujhse pooch sakte hain. Any questions, students? Students, Ritik,
ऑल क्लियर सर।
ऑल क्लियर? ओके, वेरी गुड. बिकॉज तुम क्वेश्चंस पूछते हो, मैंने इसलिए तुमसे पूछा. अगर तुम्हें क्लियर है, इट मीन्स इट वॉज गुड. यस, एनी वन एल्स? नो सर, ऑल क्लियर. वीर ज्योत, ओके, थैंक यू. सो चलिए फिर हम अटेंडेंस की तरफ चलते हैं. ठीक है, जस्ट होल्ड ऑन फॉर सेकेंड. Let me stop the presentation and recording so that we can freely.